You receive an order for 1/2 grain IM. The medication is available as 15 milligrams per mil. How many milliliters will you give the client? To solve this problem, we'll use a proportion, which is formed by setting two rates or ratios equal to each other, as we see here. As long as the units of A and C are the same, and the units of B and D are the same, then A times D will always equal B times C. So if we have one unknown value, we can solve for the unknown using this equation here. So looking at the given information to set up our proportion, we'll use the fact that the medication is available as 15 milligrams per milliliter as our first rate in the proportion. Again, we know 15 milligrams per 1 milliliter. Now this must equal the amount of medication ordered to the number of milligrams. So we'll have 1/2 grain, or 0.5 grain, to an unknown number of milliliters, which we'll call x milliliters. Now we cannot cross multiply and solve for x in this form, because notice how the units on top are not the same. Here we have milligrams, and here we have grains. So we have to either convert milligrams to grains or grains to milligrams. Let's go ahead and convert grains to milligrams. And we'll do this using the conversion 1 grain equals 60 milligrams. Now in this case, we can probably figure out that if 1 grain equals 60 milligrams, then 1/2 grain would be 30 milligrams. But let's go ahead and show how we can do this conversion using a separate proportion. So to convert grains to milligrams, we'll use this conversion as our first ratio. 1 grain is to 60 milligrams. As 1/2 grain, or 0.5 grain, is to an unknown number of milligrams, we'll say y milligrams. Notice how here the units on top are the same, the units on the bottom are the same, so we can cross multiply and solve for y. When cross multiplying, we'll leave off the units, so 1 times y would be y equals 60 times 0.5, or 60 times 1/2 would be 30. Since y equals 30, 0.5 grain is equal to 30 milligrams. So now we'll substitute 30 milligrams here for 0.5 grains. This would give us the proportion 15 milligrams is to 1 milliliter as 30 milligrams is to an unknown number of milliliters, or x milliliters. Notice now we do have the same units on top and the same units on the bottom. So now we can cross multiply and solve for x. 15 times x would be 15x, must equal 1 times 30, or 30, dividing both sides by 15. We have x equals 2. Which means if the order is for 1/2 grain, or 30 milligrams, the client should receive 2 milliliters. I hope you found this explanation helpful.